In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of teres major. That is, this muscle, this is on posterior part of shoulder joint. I am going to explain its origin, insertion, function, and anatomical relationship with other muscles. Where is teres major from? That originates from here. This is inferior angle. Inferior angle of scapula. This is origin. Insertion is on humerus. This is intertubercular groove. Intertubercular groove. This is on slightly anterior part of humerus, okay? Intertubercular groove is on anterior part of humerus. This is very, very important to understand function of teres major. I will change picture so you can see more clear relationship of its direction, okay? So this is profile view. It is a little bit hard to see teres major. This is teres major. This is posterior part. This part is origin, inferior angle. And insertion is about this part. You see, there is distance between origin and insertion. This part is posterior part. This part is anterior part. You know, there's distance. That means there is kind of a twisting direction. Does it make sense? It's from posterior and it attaches to anterior part. So now you see this orientation. Now let me talk about its function. Okay, I came back to first picture. There are three functions that teres major can do. One thing is adduction. Adduction of shoulder joint. Plus, teres major is on posterior part of shoulder joint. So, this muscle can pull humerus posteriorly. What kind of movement is that? That is extension. Extension of shoulder joint. Now, you see orientation of this muscle. This is posterior side. Insertion is anterior side. It's from posterior part and it attaches to anterior part. This twisting orientation makes what kind of movement? That's internal rotation. Internal rotation of shoulder joint. This is very, very important thing. If teres major attaches to posterior part of humerus, it would do external rotation, but insertion is on anterior part. This twisting orientation makes internal rotation. This is very important thing. So, functions of teres major is adduction, extension, and internal rotation. Now let me explain anatomical relationship with other muscles. Okay, this is closer view of posterior part. This is teres major. Major. This one is teres minor. Okay, teres minor is above teres major. You see this tiny space right here. Okay, this space is created by four structures. One is teres major. That makes this part teres major. Teres minor, about this part, superior part. And what is this part? This is triceps. Triceps brachii. And what is this one? What is this guy? This is humerus. Humerus. 1, 2, 3, 4 structure makes this space. What is this space? This is quadrilateral space. Quadrilateral space. Why is this so important? Because in quadrilateral space, one nerve penetrates this space. What is it? That is axillary nerve. Axillary nerve innervates deltoid, teres major, plus that takes sensation from shoulder joint. Okay? Now, again, axillary nerve penetrates between quadrilateral space. What happens when one of these structures get dysfunction? Let's say teres major got dysfunction. Maybe that can create impingement for quadrilateral space and axillary nerve. What happens then? That can create pain, numbness, and joint dysfunction around posterior part. What if humerus got fracture or dislocation? That also can create dysfunction for axillary nerve because these four structures surround axillary nerve as quadrilateral space. Teres major composes one part of quadrilateral space. That is why tension around this place is very, very important. In this video, I explained basic anatomy of teres major. I explained its origin, insertion, function, and anatomical relationship. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.